This is the iTIG 4 Model C. The Model C includes milli-ohm winding resistance, insulation resistance, or the Megohm measurement, DC Hipot, and the surge test. Optional features include micro-ohm winding resistance, capacitance, inductance, and impedance, as well as the RIC test, rotor influence check, advanced multi-coil, and partial discharge measurements. The Model C has one high voltage lead set, which does all the low voltage measurements and the high voltage measurements. That means you can connect one lead set one time and make all your tests without having to change leads. The leads are labeled 1, 2, and 3 for phase 1, 2, and 3. You also have one ground clip. The Model C will do all the individual measurements and tests automatically. To get started, press start. We get to the customer directory or motor database. We have already added this motor to our database. So you click the row containing the serial number and we get our motor identification. So that would be the serial number, equipment tag, location, nameplate information, and so on. We want to start a new test set. So we click test. We are now in test mode and we will work our way from left to right along the bottom row of tabs. If we're actually on the last tab here, the test summary screen, we have three fields to enter in optional information. This is great information to have for the report at the end. Test description, just a quick word describing what we are testing on. In this case, it's a stator. Next up here is the test stage. We have some pre-programmed test stages. Some ESA and IEEE test stages are already in the database. These can be added to or removed. We're going to select an incoming used test stage. Operator information, I'm just going to add my initials in this case. Next up is the setup screen, so the tab on the far left. At the top of the screen, you see the Hipot and surge test voltage formula. These are associated with the test stage we selected. In this case, it's 2 times the operating voltage plus 1000. You can always click any of the white fields and change the test voltage or use the function drop-down menu to select a different test stage if you need to do that. We can enter in the humidity. We can also enter in the winding temperature. The winding temperature will be used to correct both the winding resistance measurement and the Megohm or insulation resistance measurement. And finally here, we have the auto mode and limit setup screen. This is where we define the pass-fail criteria for this motor, as well as which test profiles we want to use for Megohm and Hipot in this case. We will run a 1 minute dielectric absorption ratio test for the Megohm or insulation resistance test. You could select a PI, for example, if you're testing a larger motor. And we will do a 1 point Hipot, that's also a 1 minute test. You can use the drop-down menu here to select different test profiles, including a 5 point or 10 point step test or a ramp test. Same motor test configuration. That means this is predefined for the serial number. Next time you test it, no setup required. Exit setup. So now we have our leads connected to the motor. So we're ready to start our test set. We work our way from left to right on the tabs along the bottom row. First up is our winding resistance measurement. Click the start coil symbol and the instrument will go through and measure winding resistance in all three phases and then calculate the max delta. If the delta is less than our 3% pass-fail criteria, we are good to proceed to the next measurement. In this case, very nice numbers, we are okay. Next up is the optional capacitance, inductance, and impedance measurement. Again, click the star coil symbol and the instrument will go through and measure the inductance, capacitance in all three phases and give you the balances of said measurements. Next up is the Megohm or insulation resistance measurement. We can select auto mode here and then we are going to run the dielectric absorption ratio test profile that we selected. Auto mode is selected, instrument is armed and ready to go. Press the red button and we will automatically increase or ramp up the test voltage to the 500 volts that we had defined on the setup screen. We're now measuring the leakage current in microamps, calculating the megohms, and then correcting the megohms to 40 degrees Celsius to be in line with the international standards. It will sit here for 1 minute before it discharges. Okay, so the test is finished. We let it run for a full minute to get the absorption ratio, which was calculated to be 1.66. That's okay. It's now fully discharged, and we are ready to move on to the Hipot test. We obviously exceeded our 100 meg pass-fail criteria, so this motor is dry and clean. We are okay to apply high voltage. So select Hipot at the top of the screen, and again, you select auto mode. It tells you in the near the bottom left corner which profile we selected, and then again, press the red button and let the instrument automatically ramp up the test voltage. It will measure the leakage current for you, and it will sit here for 1 minute before discharging. If we fail the test, you will get a audible sound letting you know that the test has been stopped and the voltage has been removed. In this case, it looks like our motor is performing well. The leakage current is still decreasing. So that is a good sign. At the end of the test set, the instrument will again automatically discharge the winding and let the operator know when it's safe to move on. The bar turns blue. We are safe to proceed. We passed the Hipot test as well. So next up is our surge test. Lead one is highlighted green. That's phase one in this case. We arm the instrument, press the red button, and the instrument will automatically set the time base and voltage scale and then drive the surge voltage to our design test voltage. Now that we have those parameters set for the oscilloscope, we select lead two or phase two, arm the instrument, press the button, and it will apply that surge pulse train in phase two. Similarly for phase three, arm the instrument, press the red button. Now we've done the surge test in all three phases. In this case, as you can see, we have a relatively large percent wave difference between phase one and phase two, as well as two and three and three and one. In this case, that's because we are testing a concentric wound motor. So this is as to be expected. If we want to verify that the insulation system is healthy, we would then do a pulse-to-pulse surge test to double check and make sure that the insulation is not breaking down, causing that percent wave difference to be high. We'll include a link in this video so you can see a demonstration of the pulse-to-pulse test as well. Another optional feature in the Model C is the partial discharge measurements. So we will select phase one again. Now select PD. I'm going to include RPDIV and RPDEV. So that's the repetitive partial discharge inception and repetitive partial discharge extinction voltages. So phase one, arm the instrument, press the red button. It'll now ramp up the voltage, the surge test voltage, in small increments and listen for partial discharge at each individual voltage step. When we find 5 out of 10 consecutive pulses with partial discharge, that's defined as the repetitive partial discharge inception voltage. We'll then continue to ramp up the voltage until we have 10 out of 10 pulses with partial discharge, or we reach our design test voltage, and then we will ramp the test voltage back down until we find the extinction voltage, which is defined as 4 out of 10 consecutive pulses. Phase one here, we got a repetitive inception voltage of about 1700 volts and an extinction voltage around 1400 volts. You could do the same thing for phase two. And for phase three. And now we have collected partial discharge data for this low voltage motor. At the end of the test set, we move on to our test summaries tab again. This is now where we get our pass-fail recommendations. We failed the surge test because we did the line-to-line comparison between the three phases, and this stator is wound in such a way that we have inherent differences in the three phases. So this is as to be expected. As a reminder, we would do a pulse-to-pulse surge test to actually verify whether the insulation system is good or not. And again, we will include a link for that demonstration in this video. When you're done with your test set, you click the folder button to exit test mode. Everything is automatically stored. There's no save operation. You can now click View Print Past Test. We get our time and date stamp for this test we just completed. We can click Display Test and go through the exact same screens that we just looked at, or you can print a report. So if I select Print Report, there's some options to include different elements in this PDF report. And I now click Print, and it will save a pre-formatted PDF file on the instrument, which can include your company logo, contact information, and so on and so forth. Once the report is printed, you can again use the folder button to exit out back to our database. And you now have some options. You can either get the raw data and printed reports off the instrument using a USB flash drive, plugging it into the USB ports, or you can use Wi-Fi or Ethernet connectivity to get it to your company server or a cloud server, whatever you prefer.